गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज क्लास 11th मैथ्स लेक्चर 7th ऑफ चैप्टर 3rd ट्रिग्नोमेट्रिक फंक्शंस. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल टुडे वी विल डिस्कस द एक्सरसाइज 3.3. सो क्वेश्चन नंबर 24th इज टू शो कोस 4x इज इक्वल टू 1 माइनस 8 साइन स्क्वायर एक्स इंटू कॉस स्क्वायर एक्स. राइट, नाउ सी वी विल टेक द लेफ्ट हैंड साइड. नाउ वी नो देर आर 3 and 4 फॉर्मूलाज ऑफ cos 2x, right? But which formula is to be used? See, on the right hand side, it is 1 minus something. Therefore, using this formula of cos 2x, which is 1 minus 2 sin square x, right? So, cos 4x can be written as 1 minus 2 sin square 2x. Why 2x? Because here it is 2x. Then you'll divide 2x by 2. So, you'll get here x. Now, here it is 4x. So, when you will divide 4x by 2, you will get 2x, right? Now, 1 minus 2 into, so in place of sin 2x, we can write 2 sin x into cos x whole square. Now, this will be 1 minus 2 into, open this square, so 4 sin square x cos square x, which is equal to 1 minus 8 into sin square x into cos square x, right? So, always see what is given in the right hand side and try to solve in that manner, right? Now, next question number 25th is cos 6x is equal to 32 into cos raised to the power 6 minus 48 cos x raised to the power 4 plus 18 cos square x minus 1. Now, see, we will again take the left hand side. Now, in the right hand side, all the values are in cos, and also here it is minus 1. So we will use the formula of cos 2x, which is 2 cos square x minus 1, right? So here you will get 2 cos square 3x minus 1. The angle will be half of this angle, so it will be 3x. Now 2 into, you know the value of cos 3x, which is 4 cos cube x minus 3 cos x and whole square minus 1. Now solve this square, 2 into, this will be a square, that is 16, cos x raised to the power 6 plus b square 9 cos square x minus 2ab, so 2ab will be minus 24 cos x raised to the power 4, this minus 1 as it is. Now multiply 2 with all of these terms, so you will get this, which is equal to the RHS, clear? Now, I am leaving exercise 3.4 because it is based on the topic of principal and general solutions of trigonometric equations, which has been deleted from your syllabus. So, we will discuss the topic in briefly later. For now, we will do some questions. So, this question says, if sin x is equal to 3 by 5, cos y is minus 12 by 13, where x and y both lies in the second quadrant. In second quadrant, sine and cosecant are positive. Okay, now find value of sine x plus y. Now we know sine x plus y is equal to sine x into cos y plus cos x into sine y, right? Now we have the values of sine x and cos y. So find out the value of cos x and sine y. So to find out the value of cos x, use the value given of sine x. So cos x is plus minus root 1 minus sin square x equal to plus minus root 1 minus sin x is 3 by 5. So its square will be 9 by 25. So you will get plus minus 4 by 5. Now because x lies in the second quadrant, therefore cos will be negative. So cos x is minus 4 by 5. Right here in the bracket that x lies in second quadrant. You have to give reason. I have skipped that. Right. Now find out the value of sin y with the help of the value given of cos y. So sin y will be plus minus root 1 minus cos square y. Cos square y will be 144 upon 169. So you will get plus minus 5 by 13. Now y also lies in second quadrant. Therefore sin y will be positive. So sin y will be 5 by 13. Now we have all the four values of sin x, cos x, sin y and cos y. So put in this formula So you will get the answer as -56/65. Clear? Now the next question is prove cos 2x into cos x/2 minus cos 3x into cos 9x/2 equal to sin 5x into sin 5x/2. See, the left hand side it is given cos A into cos B minus cos A into cos B, right? So we know the identity of 2 cos A cos B. Therefore, in the left hand side, multiply these terms with 2 and also divide it by 2. So you will get 1/2 bracket 2 into cos 2x into cos x/2 minus 2 cos 3x into cos 9x/2, right? Now apply the identity of 2 cos A cos B. 1/2 as it is into this identity of this is cos A plus B plus cos A minus B minus apply in this also cos A plus B, here minus sign will come because here it is minus, and minus cos A minus B, you can write it any way. I have written it 9x/2 minus 3x, you can also write it 3x minus 9x/2. It does not matter because cos of minus x is cos x only, right? Now this will become 1/2 into this will be cos 5x/2 plus cos, this will be now 3x/2 minus cos, this will be 15x/2 minus cos 3x/2, right? Now see, cos 3x/2 get cancelled. So you will get 1/2 inside the bracket cos 5x/2 minus cos 15x/2. So 1/2 as it is. Now cos A minus cos B is minus 2 sin A plus B. A is this, B is this, upon 2 into sin A minus B by 2. Now this will become, cancel out this 2. So minus sin, this will be now 20x/2, which is 10x, and 10x/2 will be 5x, into sin 5x/2 minus 15x/2 will be minus 10x/2, that is minus 5x upon this 2, right? Now sin of minus x is minus sin x, so this a minus will get outside and cancel out with this minus, so you will get sin 5x into sin 5x/2, which is the RHS, right? Now the next question is find the value of 10π/8. Now the angle π/8 is 22.5, 45/2, which is 22.5. So see, if there are angles greater than 90, that can be braked, but now this angle is very small, so we cannot break this angle into the addition or subtraction of two angles. Therefore we will use some identity to solve this value. Now the value of 10π/4 we know is 1, right? And this can be written as 10, 2 into π/8, because this will be π/4 only, equal to 1. Now apply the identity of 10 2x equal to 2 10x upon 1 minus 10 square x. So you will get 2 10x is this, π/8 upon 1 minus 10 square π/8 equal to 1, right? Now let this 10π/8 as x, so you will get 2x equal to, take this on the right side, 1 minus x square. Now take all of these terms to the left side, so you will get x square plus 2x minus 1 equal to 0. So x will be minus b plus minus root b square, that is 4, minus 4ac. So minus 4 into minus 1 will be plus 4 upon 2. So you will get minus 2 plus minus, this is root 8, and root 8 is 2 root 2 upon 2. Take out 2 common from the numerator and cancel with this denominator. So you will get minus 1 plus minus root 2. Now π/8 is the angle 22.5 degree. Therefore this angle will lie in the first quadrant, and in first quadrant all the trigonometric functions are positive, so 10π/8 will also be positive. Now you have to decide which values to be taken, either minus 1 plus root 2 or minus 1 minus root 2. So it is clear the positive value will be minus 1 plus root 2, because root 2 is 1.4 something, and when you will subtract 1 from the 1.4, so you will get a positive value, right? Therefore 10 pi by 8 will be minus 1 plus root 2. Clear? Now see, we will do some questions of miscellaneous. So question number 3 says, cos x plus cos y whole square plus sin x minus sin y whole square is equal to 4 cos x plus y by 2 square. So you have to prove this. Take the left hand side. You know the value of cos a plus cos b. Apply that. Also you know the value of sin a, sin x minus sin y. So apply that. So you will get 2 cos x plus y by 2 into cos x minus y by 2 whole square. Then sin x minus sin y, which is 2 cos x plus y by 2 into sin x minus y by 2 whole square. Right? Now solve these squares. So 4 cos square x plus y by 2 into cos square x minus y by 2. Now solve this square also. So plus 4 cos square x plus y by 2 into sin square x minus y by 2, right? Now from both of these terms, take out common 4 cos square x plus y by 2 into, you will get from this term cos square x minus y by 2 plus from this term sin square x minus y by 2. Now we know the value of cos square x plus sin square x, because these angles are same. So cos square this angle plus sin square this angle will be 1. 1 into this term will be 4 cos square into x plus y by 2, which is equal to the right hand side. Clear? Now question number 7 is, sin 3x plus sin 2x minus sin x is equal to 4 sin x into cos x by 2 into cos 3x by 2. Now see, we will take left hand side and you have to decide that which two terms should be taken first. So if you will take these two terms, so you will get the angle as 3x plus 2x by 2, that is 5x by 2, which is in fraction. Then 3x minus 2x by 2, which is x by 2, that is also in fraction. So therefore we will not use these two terms first. Now see, if we take this and this term together, then you will get 3x plus x by 2, the angle will be 2x, right? And you will get 3x minus x by 2, which is also the angle x. So the angles will not be in fraction if we'll take these two terms first, right? So take out these two terms first and plus sin 2x. Now apply here sin a minus sin b, which is 2 cos a plus b by 2 into sin a minus b by 2. And also write this sin 2x as plus 2 sin x into cos x. Why we have written this? See, because when you will solve this, now you will get 2 cos 2x into sin x, right? Plus, this is why, because we have written sin 2x as this, because we can now take common 2 into sin x from both of these terms. So in the bracket you will get cos 2x plus cos x. Now apply the identity of cos a plus cos b. So 2 sin x into cos a plus cos b is 2 cos a plus b by 2 and cos a minus b by 2. Now multiply these two terms, so you will get the right hand side only. 4 sin x cos 3x by 2 into cos x by 2, right? Now the next question is, if 10x is 3 by 4, x is from pi by 2 to 3 pi by 2, that is x lies in the third quadrant. Find the value of sin x by 2, cos x by 2, 10x by 2. So you have to find the value of this, and this is given that 10x is 3 by 4. Now see, cos square x, you know the value of cos square x is 1 plus cos 2x by 2, and sin square x is 1 minus cos 2x by 2. If cos square x is this, we want the value of cos x by 2. So if cos square x is this, then cos square x by 2 will be 1 plus cos x by 2, right? Half the angle of this. So here also half the angle of this. And sin square x by 2 will be 1 minus cos x by 2. So see, to get the value of cos x by 2 and sin x by 2, you need the value of cos x. And also then you will get 10x by 2. Just sin x by 2 upon cos x by 2, right? So to get all these values, we want the value of cos x. Value of 10x is given. So find out secant x. So the identity is secant square x is 1 plus 10 square x, 1 plus 9 by 16 equal to 25 by 16. So you will get secant x, take root of this, plus minus 5 by 4. Now x is given that it lies in the third quadrant. In third quadrant, only 10 and cotangent are positive. So this will be negative. Therefore, cos x will be minus 4 by 5. Now find out the value of cos x by 2, sin x by 2, and then divide sin x by 2 by cos x by 2 to get 10x by 2. So cos x by 2 is plus minus root 1 plus cos x by 2. So plus minus root 1 cos x is minus 4 by 5 upon 2 equal to plus minus root 1 by 10. Now be careful, x is given in the third quadrant. If we divide this inequality by 2, so you will get pi by 2 less than x by 2 less than 3 pi by 4. Therefore, we can see x by 2 lies in the second quadrant, right? Therefore, cos x by 2 will be negative. X by 2 lies in second quadrant. In second quadrant, cos is negative. Therefore, cos x by 2 will be minus 1 upon root 10. This is one result. Now we will find sin x by 2, which is plus minus root 1 minus cos x. So cos x is minus 4 by 5. So the minus minus will become plus. So 1 plus 4 by 5 by 2. Then you will get plus minus 3 upon root 10. Now because x by 2 lies in second quadrant, therefore sin x by 2 will be positive. So the answer is 3 by root 10. Right? Now you know the value of these two. 10x by 2 will be sin x by 2, that is 3 upon root 10 divided by cos x by 2, which is minus 1 upon root 10. Root 10 will get cancelled, so you will get the value of 10x by 2 as minus 3, right? Question 10th of miscellaneous is that sin x is given as 1 by 4. X lies in second quadrant. Find sin x by 2, cos x by 2, 10x by 2. Now see, here also in the previous question it was given 10x. Here it is given sin x. So we will follow the same pattern, find out the cos x. So cos x will be, use this identity, cos square x plus sin square x is 1. Therefore cos square x is 1 minus sin square x. That is 1 minus 1 by 16, which is 15 by 16. Now because x lies in second quadrant, so cos x will be negative. So you will get cos x as minus root 15 by 4, right? Root 15 by root of 16 is 4. Now we know the value of cos x. Find the value of cos x by 2 and sin x by 2 with the help of cos x. So cos square x by 2 is 1 plus cos x by 2. 1 minus cos x is this. So minus root 15 by 4 upon 2, which is 4 minus root 15 by 8. Now see, x is given in the second quadrant, that is pi by 2 to pi. So x by 2 will lie between pi by 4 to pi by 2. That is in first quadrant. In first quadrant, all the trigonometric functions are positive. So cos x by 2 will also be positive. So cos x by 2 will be root of 4 minus root 15 by 8, right? Now find out sin x by 2. So sin square x by 2 is 1 minus cos x by 2. So you will get 1 plus root 15 by 4 upon 2. Take LCM, you will get 4 plus root 15 by 8. So sin x by 2 will also be positive because x by 2 lies in first quadrant. So you will get positive root 4 plus root 15 by 8. Now you know the value of these two. So 10x by 2 will be sin x by 2 upon cos x by 2. Now see, root 8 will get cancelled. So you will get root 4 plus root 15 upon root 4 minus root 15, right? To avoid the root in the denominator, rationalize it by root 4 plus root 15 upon root 4 plus root 15. When you will multiply these two, root will get cancelled. You will get 4 plus root 15. And when you will multiply these two, you will get root a square minus b square. So a square is 16 and b square is, that is, square of root 15 will be 15. So you will get 4 plus root 15, because in the denominator you will get 16 minus 15, that is root of 1, which is 1. So the value of 10x by 2 is 4 plus root 15, right? So your today's homework is that you have to complete miscellaneous. Okay, thank you.